Education Station, where we learn about what's good for us and why. Today's topic being why take a cold shower. Disclaimer, I am not a medical professional, I am not a nutritionist, I am not a dietitian. I am just a simple girl with some simple facts. All right, let's talk cold showers, shall we? Overall, a cold shower is going to reduce your muscle soreness, reduce your inflammation in your body, speed up your recovery in your muscles, increase your energy, and give you a mood boost. Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you? Let me tell you, the first time that you crank that shower to cold, you're not gonna be able to breathe, you're gonna be panicking, you're gonna wanna immediately run out. But let's talk about norepinephrine. Norepinephrine. The cold rush of the water increases norepinephrine, and what norepinephrine does, norepinephrine, it increases your energy, it increases your focus, and it increases your performance outcomes. If you get to 40 degrees Fahrenheit, none of us have a thermometer, so I don't know why I'm telling you what degrees you need to get to. However, if you can get to 40 degrees in the water temperature, your blood is gonna start to surface to your skin, to your muscles. It's going to increase the blood flow immediately with that jolt of coldness. Therefore, you're really upping the circulation of blood flow in your body. It's going to your cells, to your organs, and overall increases your health. A cold shower is going to build willpower. If we're doing something that we're so resilient to and we do it consistently over and over and over again, we're gonna build up to that resilience and we're gonna become super strong. You have to use your mental strength to persevere. If you continue to use your mental strength, you build that muscle and you become mentally strong, which echoes into every avenue of your life. You build emotional resilience. Again, if this is your first time trying this, you're not gonna be able to think straight. You're not gonna be able to breathe. But what you do is you train your nervous system to be resilient to stress. Because you have a jolt of cold water to your body, you start to breathe heavily, which increases oxygen to every area of your life, which increases oxygen to every part of your body, which naturally increases your alertness. You're more alert. A lot of people will sub the cold shower for their morning coffee because they feel much more awake than caffeine could ever provide them. Not to mention, does this protect your skin and your hair? A cold shower is going to prevent all of your natural oils from being diminished. You guys are gonna love this one. It promotes weight loss. Why does it promote weight loss? When we are cold, our body has to speed up our metabolism in order to keep our bodies warm. So you're burning calories. A cold shower is also going to increase your immunity. When you increase the metabolic speed rate and you increase the activation of your immune system, you start to promote more white blood cells. When we're sick, our white blood cells are responsible for fighting off any of the bad guys. When you have more white blood cells, you have a stronger army to fight off the bad guy. A cold shower has the potential to relieve depression. We talked about norepinephrine. Now it's time to talk about noradrenaline. Sends an overwhelming electrical impulse to your brain. I'm sure you feel this when you have the cold water hitting you, but the impulses come from your nerve endings and shoot right up into your brain. And it's known to be an antidepressive reaction. So, my advice for you on today's Education Station is to turn this into an experiment. You won't be able to start with 3 minutes off the bat if you're going cold enough. So, you can start warm, but make sure you finish cold. You wanna turn that handle and just get under there and persevere and just do it. Remember, anytime you step out of your comfort zone, you grow. That's all for today, folks.